Tonight you're going to hear from percussion ensemble and then our combined concert and symphonic bands. You'll hear from symphonic winds and you'll hear from two jazz ensembles. Before we get started, I'd like to ask that you please keep your phones silent and keep the screens dark so that we don't have distraction for either the players or the audience. We appreciate that. And we hope to see you afterwards at a reception in the cafeteria. So, without further ado, Matt Larson, director of the percussion ensemble and our concert band percussion ensemble.
Thank you. Hey, I didn't mean it. Okay, sorry. Well, these guys have done a really good job. As you can hear from the last concert block, we have really improved quite a bit in a lot of our playing. We're in our next piece. It's actually based off of the Edgar Allan Poe poem of the same name, The Mask of the Red Death. And a lot of the students, very first day, said, is this from the poem? Why, yes. So I was amazed by their intelligence and how on top of it they were to pick that right up. But this one, we worked on a lot of new concepts, including 3-4, a lot of tempo changes, playing with a nice light waltz style going into this big kind of dramatic finish at the end. So please enjoy our last piece for this group, The Mask of the Red Death.
Thank you.
will bear with us, we will have a quick set change, and the Symphonicoins will join us in about 2 minutes.
Thank you.
That first piece, Dakota, is taken from a Dakota Indian melody, really neat piece. Like to mention that on that we had a few soloists. Layla Garland was playing an alto flute, for those of you that may not recognize that instrument. And we had Maya Mackey on clarinet as a soloist at the beginning, and we had Enzo Manillo on alto saxophone. So round of applause for those guys. The next piece we're going to do is entitled Seis Manuel. This is a melody based on a Puerto Rican folk dance melody. And it is kind of scored for a wind ensemble, and there are numerous opportunities for soloists in this one too. So I want to announce the names here, and hopefully I remember at the end everybody, but you're going to hear again from Maya Mackey, who will open this with a clarinet solo, but then you'll see some of the other soloists stand up a little later. You'll see a duet with Lily Waugh and Katie Braverman on flute and oboe. You'll hear a trumpet solo from Jack Keller. You'll hear a trombone solo from Frankie Casucci. And at the end, we kind of bring it to a close a little bit with a duet on clarinet with Maya Mackey and Charlie King playing along. So hope you guys enjoy this one. This is kind of a nice, light, fun tune, Seis Manuel. Thank you.
know, that last piece, that's exceedingly difficult to put together. That's one of my favorite pieces, and this ensemble, I think, really developed that sense of groove that Dr. Shelley Hansen wrote for that piece. And that was really nice. Speaking of groove, I decided for the piece that I was going to do with them, this concert block, to pick one of the pieces that has become one of our probably standard top 20 canon of the last 15, 20 years, An Undertow by John Mackey. And the fun thing about Undertow is it's written in 15-8. In other words, if you're a music reader, it's 7-8 plus 4-4, pretty much the entire piece. And it's pretty awesome. So you get the feeling of the undertow as the undercurrent of that pulse under the piece. It's never quite settled, but it is what it is, and it's really a neat piece, and they've done a really nice job putting it together. And also, not just in your program, Joe Ferguson from the Heights High Symphony decided, he's our Atlanta jazz band, to be gracious enough to join us on this piece and play the awesome string bass part. So without further ado, here's some undertow. We'll be right back. So in our set, we are going to play three tunes. The first one is going to be a swing tune called Back Online. The students worked really hard on articulations and some other things in the swing style. The second tune we're actually going to play is a jazz waltz based on the theme from Game of Thrones. And of course, because it's jazz band, it has to be called Game of Bones, featuring the trombone section. And last but not least, we will finish with a tune that takes its style from the New Orleans marches that they would do for funerals and celebrations called Second Line Tunes. And the name of that tune is Alligator Alley. I think we're gonna wait one more minute here. We have a student that had an instrument malfunction that we're trying to figure out real quick. On this first tune, Back Online, we're going to have three soloists. Yes, the sarcastic thing is fine. It's all good? All right. The three soloists on the first tune we're going to play are going to be Jervon Cole, Trayvon Upshaw, and Kayan Saleem Peoples. And here's Back Online.
Thank you.
All right, Game of Bones will feature our trombone section, like that one featured our sax section. And we will have a solo by Kay and Celine Peoples, and a duet between Kay and Jervon Cole. Here's Game of Bones. Selection for tonight, Alligator Alley has a number of soloists, and I hope I remember everybody. If I don't, I'm sure the students will keep me honest. We will have Enzo Manillo, then Tate Manny, then Kayan Salim Peoples, then Isaac Godfrey, and Trayvon Upshaw, then Jervon Cole, and finally to round us out, we will have Orson Thayer Hansen. Did I miss anybody? Cool. All right, here's Alligator Alley. Thank you.
On that first tune, Acronym Blues, heard from soloist Frankie Casucci on the trombone, Trayvon Upshaw on tenor, and Emmett Creamer on piano. This next piece we're going to play, Kavanaugh, yet? Go ahead. Kavanaugh Bay, this is a jazz and a waltz style. You're going to hear from Mario on tenor and Grant Gober on. You're playing on trumpet or flugel? On flugelhorn. And you'll also hear the rest of the section back there is going to be playing some of the melodic parts of this on flugelhorns. So, Kavanaugh Bay. We got one more number in the book for you tonight. This is, I know the other band played a second lion tune. This is also a second lion piece. It's entitled Kick It. Let's see, who's all on this one? Starts with Noah Frazier on bass trombone. We'll hear from Shannon on alto saxophone, and you'll hear from Joe Ferguson on bass, and then we're going to have two trombone players, Cameron McIntosh and Helen Barr. They're going to trade fours on the last chorus of this one. Before we play the last tune, though, I'd like to first of all invite you to reception afterwards, and then also I'd like to take just a minute and thank Dr. Marzola, Matt Larson for their work in the department. We also have a coach, Tim McDonald, that comes in, and it's a collective effort to put on these programs. I certainly wouldn't be fair to not acknowledge all the people involved in that. I'd also like to thank Keith Newman and the stage crew for running sound, doing lights, and doing all the stage setup and stuff for us. So appreciate all the other people that are helping to put this program on. So thank them and kick it. Thank you. Thank you. I forgot to mention Serena Blaylock on the drum set, so at the end, different space in the song, forgot to mention.